From the RSNA, I'm Dr. Linda Chu and welcome to the Radiology Journal podcast. Before we dive into today's program, I want to tell you about virtual access for RSNA 2023. Have you registered for RSNA 2023 virtual access? The physical doors to our annual meeting may have closed, but you still have time to access valuable learning opportunities. Discover the future of medical imaging. Immerse yourself in the latest technology and sharpen your skills with high-impact learning while you earn CME. We have everything you need, all in one place. Register now for virtual access at meeting.rsna.org. Now back to our program. Today's topic is variability in prostate MRI quality. The accuracy of our multiparametric prostate MRI interpretation critically depends on the quality of prostate MRI exams. The prostate imaging quality PiQAL score from the Precision trial is the first standardized scoring system to evaluate image quality of prostate MRI. It is a 5-point scale that assesses image quality against a set of objective technical requirements detailed in PI-RADS, together with visual criteria obtained from the image. A PiQAL score of 1 or 2 means that the study is non-diagnostic. A PiQAL score of 3 means that the study is of sufficient diagnostic quality. And a PiQAL score of 4 and 5 means that it is possible to rule in and rule out all clinically significant lesions. Scanners can only be PiQAL 5 if they are fully adherent to the PI-RADS version 2.1 technical recommendations. There was a recent study published in Radiology that prospectively evaluated the quality of all MRI scanners taking part in the Global PRIME clinical trial. Now, Dr. Refki Nicola will lead our in-depth discussion on prostate MRI quality.
Welcome to the RSNA Radiology Journal podcast. I'm your co-host and assistant editor for the podcast, Refki Nicola, and today on the podcast, we are talking to Dr. Francisco Giganti, Associate Professor of Radiology from University College London Hospital, regarding his recent article entitled Global Variations in Magnetic Resonance Imaging Quality of the Prostate. Welcome to the podcast.
Hello, everybody.
Tell me, when you were putting together this project, did you take into consideration different vendors for the project?
So basically, we accepted all vendors because we sent an open invitation to any center in the world that performed prostate MRI and was interested in taking part in the PRIME trial. That is a trial study comparing biparametric versus multiparametric in prostate cancer. So basically, we accepted all vendors, and this is also shown in the paper where we had scans from different vendors across the world.
Tell me, what were the requirements for enrollment in this trial when you started?
So we had basically three main requirements. So the first one was that centers needed to perform prostate MRI and MRI targeted biopsies. The second requirement was that centers needed to be able to provide all the data for the biopsy cancer detection rates. And the final requirement was that the MR scanner that they wanted to use for the trial was not older than 10 years when they submitted the images.
Can you tell us how many countries and centers were involved in the beginning, and then how many did you end up with?
Sure. Basically, we started with 66 centers from 22 countries, and these expressed interest in the PRIME trial. Then 25 centers did not respond, so we ended up with 41 centers from 18 countries, and this was for phase one of the study. And then we had 25 centers that basically, five centers, that did respond again to the feedback. So basically, we ended up with 36 centers in phase two. So at the end, we had 36 centers for phase two of the study.
Why did you decide to pursue this project if there are already specific standards and technical requirements which are set by the ACR as well as the ESUR?
So that's an interesting point because you all know that we have technical requirements that are clearly in the PI-RADS document. So we know basically that we have guidelines how to acquire T2 waves deep fusion wave images and DCE images of good diagnostic quality, as outlined in the PIRATS recommendations. But actually, despite these publications, there have been no previous studies demonstrating the variation of prostate MR quality or adherence to the standards. So this is the reason why we conceived the study. So we wanted to give the first glimpse, as the study is named, into this variation.
From the paper, there was mention of a phase one and phase two. Can you describe the findings of each of the phase?
Sure. As I said before, in phase one, we had 41 centers from 18 countries. So what we saw here was that only 32% of the scanners achieved the PIRQOL score of 5. So as you know, the PIRQOL score is a scoring system used to evaluate image quality of prostate MRI. And if you have a PIRQOL score of 4 or 5, this means that the quality of your images is good or really good. And after feedback, and this is phase two, basically, when we provided feedback to the centers and they implemented the changes, we saw that the percentage of PIRQOL score of 5 in the scans was much higher, was 97% of the scanners. We saw basically a very steep increase in terms of image quality between phase one and phase two.
What were some of the common issues facing most centers?
So basically, we found three main issues for each sequence. So for example, for T2 weight imaging, we saw that we asked the centers, the majority of the centers, to adjust the implant resolution in order to meet the recommendations, the PARA guidelines. We also asked to acquire additional orthogonal separate planes for T2 weight imaging. And also we saw that some centers did not adhere to this slice thickness. So we asked them to change this slice thickness to 3 millimeters as per PARA's recommendation. In terms of diffusion weight imaging, we this was very common. We asked the centers to include acquired or calculated HIV value or 1400 or higher. We also asked some centers to decrease the slice thickness to 4 millimeters or less as per PIRATS recommendations, you know. And also some centers had to reduce the field of view as per PIRATS recommendations. And finally, for DCE sequences, which basically were the sequences with the greatest variability, we asked some centers to adjust the temporal resolution to a maximum of 15 seconds recommendations. And also we asked them to use fast suppressed sequences. And finally, to use, as you know, a power injector with a pump speed of 3 millimeters per second, as reported in the PIRATS guidelines.
What are some of the initiatives that centers can take to improve image quality?
So this is a really interesting point because I think one of the best initiatives that centers can make is to liaise with academic centers, if they're not academic, because of the experience that the researchers have in academic centers in terms of image quality. And this is actually the first initiative that this could be done, basically collaboration between academic and non-academic centers. The other initiative that I think would be really important is to check if the scanners are calibrated and checked regularly, and if the prostate MR protocols are compliant with the PIRATS technical recommendations. Also, I think it's really important if the image quality is evaluated for scan routinely. And also, it's really important to know if the radiographer, for example, have a license to repeat or interrupt the sequences, if, for example, there are artifacts from motion or rectal air. So I think, I mean, the main, the key point here for centers that want to improve the quality of the scanners is to start using the DCE scoring system to improve the quality, but also adhere to the PIRATS recommendations.
What are your, finally, what are some of the major conclusions that readers can derive from this study?
So basically, I think, again, there are three main major conclusions. So we have seen that the greatest variation lies in DCE sequences. So it's really important that centers look at the parameters for DCA sequences, for example, temporal resolution, fast suppression. The other major conclusion is that there is substantial global variation in prostate mark quality, and we need to improve it. And this is the first glimpse into this. And finally, we have seen that after simple modifications, and as I have said before, we can improve prostate MRI quality. So again, it's an overall effort to improve the quality of prostate MRI just doing simple modifications to the MR protocols.
Thank you so much, Dr. Giganti. You can read the entire article in the December 2023 edition of the Radiology Journal. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Dr. Giganti, for highlighting this global variation in prostate MRI quality. There is certainly room for improvement, especially for DCE images. And adherence to the technical recommendations outlined in the PIRATS guidelines can significantly improve the quality of the scanners. This wraps up this week's podcast. Thank you for tuning in and supporting our podcast program. Please subscribe today on Apple Podcasts, Google Play, or Spotify. Come back next week for our new episode. Take care.